Welcome back, Penn High School, to this week's edition of PNN. Today is February 14th, also known as Valentine's Day. I'm your anchor, Madisyn Renbarger.
And I'm Ty Magruder. Here for this week's news and announcements, let's jump into Madisyn's package about mental health.
From a young age, we're told to express our emotions and that it's okay not to be okay. That's why I went to therapy for my anger issues when I was 4. But when I was 12 and went back to therapy because I was severely depressed, in an attempt to help, my mom told me that I should only tell my close friends because parents didn't want to have a child over who they thought would harm themselves, even if I wasn't one of them. And while that hurt to hear, she was right, and I would learn that it was common not to tell people. That's because of the stigma around mental illness. The mental illness stigma is classified by two different types. First, there is a social stigma, which is the prejudiced attitudes conveyed through people that society fuels with myths about mental illness.
So when we're discussing things like mental health, it's important to be mindful of the way and that you address these things. When you go and say words like, oh, that person's psycho, or like they're a little bit crazy.
Second is the self-perceived stigma. This is an internalized stigma by the person enduring mental illness.
It invalidates these struggles and that everyone has with their mental health because of the fact that you're making it seem like it all boils down to this one point. It's also super negative. And honestly, we don't need that type of energy when we're talking about serious issues like this.
As long as I can remember, whenever I've been fidgety or hyper, friends and teachers told me that I was acting very ADD or ADHD. ADHD, or attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, is one of the most commonly diagnosed mental disorders in children. This is because whenever a child is fidgety or has trouble paying attention, like myself, people automatically assume that their child has ADHD and that it needs to go away. I see this stigma in my school when kids are tapping their feet or someone else tells them it's so ADHD. Or when I'm having trouble focusing and people tell me to just focus. But when I say it's my ADHD, they say, oh yeah, I have that too. What people don't understand is that while everyone might have a day where they're having trouble focusing, not everyone has ADHD. A good YouTube channel that explains ADHD is How to ADHD. Part of the reason for this stigma around mental illness is that it is glamorized by mass media like TV and movies. Anorexia isn't a disorder that a good old Danny Tanner pep talk can fix. It can stay with you forever and be very damaging. Depression isn't a pretty girl with her mascara running. It can be feeling nothing or not brushing your hair for a week, but it manifests itself differently in every person. Bipolar disorder can't be cured away with any amount of book throwing, football game betting, dance competition rehearsing, and Jennifer Lawrence loving, like in Silver Linings Playbook. In real life, it's very hard to manage and can be detrimental. Self-harm isn't slitting your wrists in the bathtub like in 13 Reasons Why. It's scars that never go away and not being able to look at a razor the same way. So when people are forced to see the reality of mental illness, it's impossible to relate because of the glamorization that TV puts on it. Another reason the stigma of mental illness is so prevalent is because of the undereducation about mental illnesses.
So on the undereducation of mental health in schools, I believe that here at Penn, we're trying to take steps to raise awareness for mental health through initiatives such as advisory in the SEL lessons. However, we are still working on how we can adapt those to students' needs and desires. We've made an attempt in the health classes to educate students, which is of course a noble attempt. However, we are very much isolating our education of mental health to those particular areas rather than allowing it to be something that's part of the integral curriculum in our schools. For example, if you walk into your English class or your social studies class, the probability that your teacher's going to look at you and say, hey, how's your mental health doing, is very, very slim. And until we integrate that culture in Penn, we won't truly destigmatize mental health.
We work actively in order to create the conversation around it, because mental health is something that everybody has regardless of like whether or not they have an illness or a disorder.
This stigma doesn't have to exist. World Mental Health Day is Saturday, October 10th, 2020. Take this opportunity to help destigmatize mental illness by wearing green, posting positive messages.
Be open about the way that you talk about mental health. It is just like physical health, and everyone should be aware of the fact that there are ups and there are downs. And I think just being able to listen and talk openly about it helps to destigmatize it a lot.
And whether you personally are struggling with mental health, or you know somebody, or you just want to learn more about it, PATH is a great resource for you to just educate yourself, meet new people, and learn about mental health.
Or even donate to a charity like Child Mind Institute or the National Alliance Against Mental Illness. If you or a loved one is experiencing mental health issues, contact someone using the numbers below for free confidential help.
Thanks, Madisyn.
NHS applications are due today, February 14th. If you have any questions about NHS this spring semester, email Mr. Lockwood at jlockwood@phm.k12.in.us or visit him in room 130.
Now to Liam Palmer with the weather.
Hello, Penn High School. I'm your new weatherman, Liam Palmer, taking over for Josh Wyatt. Today, I will be bringing you the upcoming forecast. Let's get into the report. Today, February 14th, it is partly sunny but cold, with a high near 17 and a low near 7. On Saturday, it will be mostly cloudy, with a high near 34 and a low around 27. There is a 40% chance of snow. Come Sunday, it will still be mostly cloudy, with a high near 38 and a low around 31. There is a 30% chance of both rain and snow. With the weather remaining this cold and chances of snow, make sure to wear a jacket when going out. This will be the weather at Penn High School.
Good morning, Penn High School. My name is Cameron Stuggy, here for your sports this week. Last Saturday, regionals were held at Penn for wrestling. 8 wrestlers will be going to semi-state this Saturday. Those wrestlers are Ryan Purvis, Braden McMillan, Vince Sparrow, Grant Mallory, AJ Steenbeck, Ben Call, Peyton Kendall, and Hezzy DeVault. Semi-state will be held this Saturday in East Chicago. Make sure to congratulate them for their impressive performances. Congratulations to Trinity Clinton on winning the NIC's MVP and for being put on first-team all-conference. Congratulations to Reagan Pate for being placed second-team all-conference, and Antrius Shelton for honorable mention. The Lady Kingsmen beat the Warsaw Tigers in a very close playoff game, 45-44, on Saturday the 8th. Trinity Clinton led the Lady Kingsmen in scoring 16, and Reagan Pate added 13. During that game, Reagan Pate scored her 1,000th point. Great job, Reagan. Also, during that game, Jade Patton and Trinity Clinton had 4 rebounds. They'll play Crown Point on Saturday the 15th at 10 a.m. Great job, ladies. Keep up the good work. Boys and girls swimming and diving competed on Saturday. They beat St. Joseph with a final score of 515-503. In the performance, Penn upset St. Joe. Lauren Pisnewick won 2 events on Saturday. Last week, the boys basketball team played the Riley Wildcats. They lost in a close one against the Wildcats, with the final score being 55-52. Derek Durda led the Kingsmen, scoring 18. Tobias Patton scored 13, and Jaden Doster contributed with 7. On Tuesday, they played a road game and won in dominant fashion, beating Bremen 59-40. Derek Durda scored 16, Carter Hickey scored 10, and Joe Smith had 9. They play Elkhart Central today, February 14th. Good luck, Kingsmen. The 28-11-2 Penn hockey team played St. Joe last weekend on Saturday, February 8th. Penn won the game 4-1. The hockey team will play in the MHSHL tournament this weekend. They play at Adams tonight in the icebox at 8:30. Penn may have games on Saturday and Sunday depending on how they perform in the tournament. That's all for sports this week. Now back to the desk.
Thanks, Liam and Cameron.
The robotics 9th and 10th grade teams went to the FTC Northern League Championship on February 1st and 2nd at South Bend Success Academy. With a total of 22 teams, 3 Penn teams made it to finals. 2 teams, Bravo Bots and Beta Bots, won championships with a Penn team with all rookies as runner-ups. Congratulations to all of you.
Any boys who want to try out for the boys' golf team, there was a meeting yesterday in room 165. If you missed the meeting and would still like to try out, go by the athletics office by Sunshine Hallway to find out more information.
Attention to all seniors, it's time for your yearbook quotes. Please come up with short, appropriate quotes and send them to pennxyearbook@gmail.com. Quotes will be accepted until March 26. Any quotes submitted later will not be accepted for the yearbook. It looks like this is the end of our show. For more information on news and announcements, visit our website at pnn.phmschools.org.
Or you can check out our Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, or even our new TikTok at Penn News Network. Have a great weekend, Kingsmen.